Okay, so a very good evening to all of you. This video is a continuation on the diseases of the skin, where we are going to completely break down erythema multiforme. By the end of the video, you will know everything you need to know about it. And for more such videos, you can check out the playlist on oral pathology under the channel Truth Be Told. So, getting right into erythema multiforme, this is an acute inflammatory disease affecting your skin and mucous membranes that cause a variety of lesions and hence the term multiforme. So note, this is an acute inflammatory disease. So the onset over here is acute, and why it occurs is because of a hypersensitivity reaction, right? There is a hypersensitivity reaction to drugs and infections. Your typical targets are the skin and mucous membrane, and here they cause a variety of lesions, which gives it the name multiforme. It presents with a wide spectrum of severity, ranging from mild to severe. So, in the mild, you have erythema multiforme minor, ranging to erythema multiforme major. Apart from that, Stevens-Johnson syndrome and toxic epidermal necrolysis were also considered part of the spectrum, but now they are considered a separate entity because of the etiopathology. In the etiopathology, it occurs because of a hypersensitivity reaction. Now, again, as I've already told you, this is a hypersensitivity reaction where your T cells go and attack your keratinocytes, and they cause apoptosis and necrosis of your keratinocytes, right? This we'll study in the histopathology as well. The reason why your T lymphocytes attack the keratinocytes is believed to be because of precipitating factors or triggers, and these can either be drugs or infections. The drugs most commonly implicated are the NSAIDs, which include aspirin, sulfonamides, and anticonvulsants such as phenytoin. Infectious agents most commonly implicated are the herpes simplex virus infection. This is the most common infection. And apart from that, you have mycoplasma, histoplasmosis, infectious mononucleosis, etc. But the main reason on a lot of cases is the herpes simplex virus infection. The clinical manifestation of erythema multiforme minor is mainly a cutaneous lesion with mild or no mucosal involvement. So again, let me show you in this diagram, you mainly have a localized skin involvement. So one, there is a localized skin involvement, and two, the mucosal involvement is none or mild. By mild, I mean one surface, only one mucous membrane, most commonly the mouth. However, on the other hand, if you look at erythema multiforme major, there is involvement of the skin plus two or more mucous membranes, right? So again, let me write that down. Mucous membrane, two or more. So in this image here, you have involvement of the tongue, the lips, as well as the conjunctivitis of the eye. If you look at the lesions that you see, first of all, in the clinical findings, it is common in a younger age group between 20 to 40 years. It is acute in onset with a female predilection and prodromal symptoms of fever, malaise, headache, sore throat, rhinorrhea, and cough 1 week before appearance of the lesions. Now that we know that erythema multiforme minor consists of mainly skin lesions and major consists of many mucous membrane lesions, let's start by talking about the skin lesions. So in the skin lesions, they take several forms, which is why it is called multiforme. They appear rapidly over a few days as macules that become papules. So macules are nothing but flat or circumscribed areas of discoloration, which eventually become papules. Papules are areas of pinpoint elevations less than 1 centimeter. So they begin as the discolorations on the skin, such as macules, which eventually transform into raised papules. And the site of occurrence is primarily in the hands, moving centripetally towards the trunk. The most common sites being the extremities, face and neck. So here I'll draw a person affected by, say, herpes simplex virus infection. After 1 week, he starts to develop skin lesions and they begin to appear in your extremities first and then move centripetally towards the trunk. The main sites of involvement are your face, neck and extremities. Coming to the pathognomic lesion of erythema multiforme, this is called the iris lesion or the target lesion or the bull's eye lesion. Right, so here you have the target, iris or bull's eye lesion. Now what happens here is, this is like the game of bull's eye that you play here. If I score in the center, I get the highest mark. So starting with the center, here you have an area of dusky red, characterized by intense inflammation with a blister or necrosis. So in this diagram, I have it over here. There is a central area of dusky red color, which represents a blister or necrosis. Next to that, I have an area of pale color, right? So here I have a pale color, which represents edema, and it may be slightly raised. Moving to the third layer, again, I have a zone of intense erythema. So again, in the third zone, I have erythema, a layer of erythema, and this is the final layer. So if I have to draw it all again, I have a central zone of dusky red color, which is surrounded by a pale area, and then again a zone of intense erythema, which looks like the iris of your eye. And this is the pathognomic lesion of erythema multiforme. So again, revising, here you have the classic lesion, which consists of a central blister or necrosis with concentric ring of erythema or color. So central ring of necrosis with concentric ring of erythema. The oral manifestations. So we have covered the skin. Coming to the mucosal involvement, in the mucosa, the most common site of involvement is the oral mucosa, up to 70% of the cases. The other mucosa involved are the genitourinary, respiratory and conjunctival mucosa. In the oral lesions, they begin as erythematous macules that go on to develop vesicles or bullae or blisters that ulcerate and result in pseudomembrane formation. They are ill-defined ulcers and there may be extensive lip involvement with inflammation, ulceration and crusting. So if I show you over here, there is involvement of the buccal mucosa, and in this image you have involvement of the lips. It would have initially begun as a discoloration or an erythematous macule, which would have formed a blister, a fluid-filled blister, which would have ruptured to give rise to an ulcer, which is covered by pseudomembrane. So here you have a large ulcer, which is covered by pseudomembrane and also shows you areas of crusting. Apart from erythema multiforme minor and major, the other forms I told you about were Stevens-Johnson syndrome and the toxic epidermal necrolysis. So in Stevens-Johnson syndrome and TEN, it is mainly precipitated by drugs. In SJS, there are generalized vesicles over the skin and the body, where there is involvement of not only your skin and mouth, but also the eyes and the genitals. In toxic epidermal necrolysis, there is more than 30% of the skin that is involved, which involves slowing of the skin and mucosa in large sheets. So there are large sheets of the skin that are basically peeled away, and this gives the appearance of a widespread scalding burn. In the histopathology, because your T lymphocytes go and attack your keratinocytes, definitely the first thing you see is apoptosis of the basal layer. Here you have degeneration of the basal layer. Then you have liquefaction degeneration of the superficial keratinocytes, as well as intracellular edema of the spinous layer. So in the first layer, just remember that you have degeneration and necrosis of the epithelium. Now coming to the second layer, which is the connective tissue, here you see dilation of the capillaries, right? So here you see dilation of the capillaries plus infiltration of inflammatory cells such as your T cells and macrophages. So there is perivascular infiltration of lymphocytes and macrophages. If you look at the junction between the dermis and the epidermis and the dermis, you see the formation of a vesicle. So this is your third zone where you see a subepidermal vesicle. So again, quickly revising, in the superficial layer, you have degeneration of the keratinocytes. You have a subepidermal vesicle, and then you have erythema in the form of dilation of capillaries and inflammatory infiltrate in the form of T cells and macrophages. The treatment, because in mild oral erythema multiforme, it is self-limiting, the treatment is mainly supportive. So this involves topical or systemic analgesics for pain. In severe cases, we recommend systemic corticosteroids with topical steroids for the oral lesions. If it was preceded by a herpes simplex virus infection, it is implicated to use antiviral medications, and other treatment modalities include dapsone, methotrexate, azathioprine, and hydroxychloroquine. The questions before we end the video are, name the two clinical variants of erythema multiforme. Name two precipitating factors for erythema multiforme. Name the pathognomic lesion of erythema multiforme. Apart from that, also, which of the following diseases show iris lesion or foci lesion of the hand, which is a frequently repeated question in entrance exams. To review whatever we have studied that erythema multiforme is an acute inflammatory disease of the skin and mucous membranes. It is a hypersensitivity reaction in relation to drugs and infections. It has a spectrum of activity resulting from erythema multiforme minor to major to Stevens-Johnson syndrome to toxic epidermal necrolysis. The clinical findings, we have studied it both for erythema multiforme minor and major, which included the pathognomic lesions or the target or iris or bullseye lesions. We have studied the oral manifestations, which were initially erythematous macules, which formed your large ill-defined ulcers covered by pseudomembrane. Histopathologically, we have seen the three layers, which are your epidermis, dermis, and the subepidermal layer. With this, we come to the end of the video. I hope this video helps you to study whatever you have to. And if it does, then please do like, share, comment, subscribe, and help this video reach other students who might as well need it. So with this, I end the video. I hope you enjoyed it the way I enjoyed teaching it, and have a good day.